Keep it going for Billy Bats. All right. And just for the record, I only respond to green lights. Green lights, no. I will keep an eye out for the red light. How we doing, Van Nuys Comedy Club?
Super stoned.
Oh my God. I just got here from Las Vegas. Fuck yeah. That's right. So, everybody having fun up in here?
Yeah.
That's cool. I'm Jeffrey Peterson. You may have seen me on THC. I mean TMZ. Yeah. Love doing comedy. Definitely beats my old job. Sunday school teacher. Yeah, I used to teach kids at a church in Burbank for about 3 years till they realized I wasn't Jesus. So who's drinking tonight? Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Who's drinking on a Wednesday night?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, you guys are drinking?
Drunk.
And I'm jealous? Because I had to quit drinking. Yeah. Which really sucks for me because I'm Irish. And it especially sucks around the holidays, like St. Paddy's Day, right? All you fuckers out at the bar drinking that green beer and stuff. Best I could do is a shamrock shake. Last year I got a little crazy though. I took my shamrock shake home and I set it down and I just put one little drop of LSD in there. It was magically delicious. Speaking of LSD, give it up for Franchi San Pedro. That's where I get all my good acid from. Yeah, San Pedro. You know what goes on down there. People staring at Catalina Island. Going, God, I wish I lived there. So, speaking of drinking, have you ever been so drunk you peed in someone else's pants? That just happened to me. Come on, dude. Stay in your stall, please. Wow, yeah. What a great time to be alive. We are in the Twilight Zone. 2017, we are in the Twilight Zone. I mean, take a look at it. Our president is a former reality TV star. Lady Gaga is singing for Metallica. And Saturday Night Live is funny again. We're in the Twilight Zone. Speaking of the Grammys, you guys see the Grammys?
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or as I like to call it, Lady Gaga? There was a commercial, I don't know, it came by real fast. Schick just came out with a new razor for the unisex world. It's called Lady Metallica. All right, that was just for me. So I was hoping. Wow. So, yeah, we have Trump as our president. And I don't know, Hillary might have been a good president, you guys. And I'll tell you why. Because Bill Clinton would have made a great first lady. Wouldn't he? I'm saying. And you know, the thing is, I'm kind of glad Trump is president, and not for any political reason, but because of the fact of the candidates that were running, he's the one guy I can do a solid impression of. In fact, every person in this room can do a Donald Trump impression. I'll teach you guys how. You want to learn how to do a Donald Trump impression?
Yeah! All
right. In order to do a Donald Trump impression, you just simply have to make your mouth a butthole. Make your mouth a butthole when you chug. It's very simple. Keep your mouth in the butthole position the entire time. Don't take your mouth out of the butthole position. Okay? Very happy with the results of the presidency. Look at my wife. Actually, I'm very pissed off. ISIS has got me very angry. But you can't tell because my mouth's a butthole. I need a new president, President Butthole. Please call him that from now on, President Butthole. Wow, I'm a little disappointed in Obama there. I mean, I was really expecting for him to step out on a high note, literally. It would have been great if he would have went, it's been great serving you for the last 8 years. Michelle and I have really enjoyed the company we've kept with the American people. But I'm going to do one more thing before I leave office, and that's legalize marijuana across the board.
Woo!
Snoop Dogg, you want to pass me that big fat blunt? God, wouldn't that have been great? Too bad that didn't happen. So, wow. I just came here from Las Vegas, and just like California, they legalized weed in Las Vegas and California. Give it up for that. It's about that time, right? I was living in Denver, Colorado. And do you know they made $1 billion in cannabis sales last year?
Wow.
Yeah, and that was just to me. Yeah. I'm broke, but I'm very stoned.
Yeah.
Oh my God, there's a whole generation of young people who've never purchased their marijuana from a dealer. Have you guys thought about this? There's a whole generation of young people, they've only bought their pot from one of these dispensaries. They don't know what we went through, you guys.
That's right.
Yeah, they don't know what it's like to have to watch your dealer's baby. As he runs to Kraken Auto Parts and returns with no auto parts. What a total dick. Yeah, Colorado is crazy because they had pro-pot commercials. We remember the anti-pot commercials, but how about this? Pro-pot commercials. This is real. I was in Colorado, and this is an actual commercial. It's Mile High Pipe and Tobacco's back to school sale. Who is this for? You know, this is kind of interesting. Scientists and historians, I'll let you finish your conversation, go ahead. Anyways, scientists and historians recently discovered that William Shakespeare was high on marijuana.
Yeah.
Yeah, when he wrote those sonnets and plays, you guys. I think it went something like this. You might want to hear this part, guys. To be or not to be. What the fuck was I saying? Billy, you can tell people you had Shakespeare on this stage. I mean, come on. Yeah, it's going to be great when they make the pro-pot commercials and corporate America gets involved. Wouldn't it be cool if they had like a MasterCard debit commercial for pot? It'd be like, 1/8 ounce of OG Master Kush, $65. Hand-blown glass pipe, $45. 1968 Volkswagen bus, $800. Having a cop drive past you while you're getting stoned, priceless. That laugh was great, thank you. That was enough for everybody. How about those Dos Equis commercials, right? There's a great, I love the Dos Equis campaign, right? The most interesting man in the world. Why not the most interesting stoner in the world, right?
Yeah.
He's the most interesting stoner in the world. He smokes more marijuana than the Wu-Tang Clan. He considers chicken pot pie a three-course meal. Every watch, clock, or timepiece he owns is permanently set at 4:20. He's known Snoop Dogg since he was a pup. He claims to have coined the phrase puff puff pass. In the presence of law enforcement, he can literally smell bacon. He's the most interesting stoner in the world. I don't normally smoke marijuana, my friends, but when I do it every day for 30 years. Stay stony, my friends. I think it's high time they made the news for potheads, right? It's legal, so when I watch the news and I'm stoned, I get paranoid. It freaks me out, especially in LA. Like, you turn on the news, like, oh shit, what did I get myself into?
Yep.
That's why they need to ease us into that. Be like, KTHC News, I'm Kent Cushley. Our top story tonight, the McRib is back. We can handle that. You know, wouldn't that be great? Game shows for stoners? How about that? Game shows for stoners. Repeat the question. We've got no answers on the board, but we'll be back tomorrow to repeat the question. I'm telling you, it's a mixed up world.
That's
speaking of pot, give it up for Doughboy, my buddy.
Yay!
That guy. Yeah, man. He was talking about all the good food in here. I'm actually trying to trim down this year, lose some weight. I am on this new fad diet called poverty. Keeping the carbs really low. Thank you very much. So I am from Las Vegas. I'm living in Las Vegas. How many people have been to Las Vegas? What a crazy ass town Vegas is. I mean, for one thing, it gets hot there. I mean, really hot in the summertime. Let me tell you, last summer, it was so hot in Vegas, I paid a hooker to blow on me. Just for the breeze. Vegas is nuts. Get this, guys. In Las Vegas now, they have a Taco Bell cantina. A Taco Bell that serves alcohol.
What?
Isn't Taco Bell the bad decision that usually comes after alcohol? I don't think you want to mix the two. Wow, Vegas is a crazy town. Pickup lines. Never heard a pickup line like this in L.A. I am standing at a bus stop in the middle of the day. This 40-something tweaker chick is pushing her bicycle. And she stops and she makes eye contact with just me, of all the people. She goes, well, look at you with all your teeth. Yes. That's a Vegas line. Weird shit. Vegas is weird. Weird shit that never happened anywhere else. Could be 2 o'clock in the morning, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It really doesn't matter. There's a Mexican dude at my door ready to sell me a bootleg DVD. Now, how he knew I wanted Captain America right then, I don't know, but I did. So, we made a deal. But the thing is, it's Vegas, so it's a gamble. I got all excited, bought a DVD of Pacific Rim. Put it in my DVD player. Turned out to be Asian porn. Let me tell you, those Asian dudes have little dicks. And so do the chicks. Yes, I paid $5. Tell me you got that joke. They don't get that in Utah. Hopefully you guys get it here. Wow.
Love you long time.
So, met my girlfriend in Las Vegas. Very excited about, we've been together for 4 years.
Yay!
Thank you. I got some really great news to share. My girlfriend recently became a grandmother. Yeah, thanks. It's great news for me because it makes me a grandmother fucker. Relationships are tough. The thing is, who's here in a relationship? Any couples here? Nope, just prostitutes and Johns? Okay. Relationships are tough. And let me tell you, the phone is what messes me up more than anything. Yeah. First of all, spell check can suck my duck. Secondly, it's autocorrect that screws me up. Yeah, the other day I'm in an argument with my girlfriend, you know, just feverishly trying to save our relationship through a text. And there goes autocorrect, swoops in and screws me up. I chose the word baby, it chose bitch. That's not my fault. Technology. Yeah, it's a bitch. Been together with my girlfriend for a while, and, you know, when you're just having sex and then you go to each other's two separate dwellings, you don't often get to see everything about each other. But when you're living with each other, it gets a little freaky, right? My girlfriend started displaying some weird sleeping habits. Yeah, she was like in the middle of the night making a bunch of, like, you know, putting clothes in the laundry and laundry in the oven and stuff. This weird stuff. I was like, what the hell's going on? I found out she is a sleepwalker. Yeah, found out she's a sleepwalker. Did a little research, went online, did a little research, and scientists say it's not safe to wake a sleepwalker, but they don't say anything about fucking them. Come on, that's my only way to cheat. What she doesn't know won't hurt her, or maybe it will if I do it right. Yes, I saw the light, Billy, so I'm gonna wrap this up. Look at this, I'm acknowledging the light, so you don't have to sit there and wonder. Give it up for Billy putting on a great show. Billy always puts on a great show. It's been wonderful to work with you over the years.
Leave your name and just number after the tone.
A couple quick things, guys. First of all, I'm excited. Who likes the superhero movies?
Yay.
I love the superhero movies. I'm excited about the fact that they're making a Wonder Woman movie. It's about to come out.
Yay.
Wow.
And it's the cool thing is Wonder Woman's got some cool superpowers. She's got the bracelets, they'll stop a bullet. That's cool. She's got a lasso that'll make men tell the truth. Also cool. She's got an invisible jet. How she finds that shit, I don't know. But that's not her coolest superpower. Wonder Woman's coolest superpower is that bitch can get dressed in seconds.
Yeah.
What woman doesn't want to be that, and what guy doesn't want that in a woman, right? Come on.
Yeah.
All right, here's my final thing. Hollywood is running out of ideas. Proof positive of that is they make Lego movies. And they pay stars big ass money to be in these Lego movies. So when they're done making all the shitty ones, they're going to make the ultimate Lego movie. Legos. Expendables. Starring Sylvester Stallone.
Yo, I'm gonna need you guys help on this one, right?
Arnold Schwarzenegger. Get down! Danny Trejo. Machete on Lego. Samuel L. Jackson.
What's that Lego doing on a horse?
Jason Statham. Look, I don't got fucking children, and I don't want to be in a stupid fucking Lego movie. Gary Busey. Look, do you guys know that Lego makes everything go on? Matthew McConaughey.
All right. Hey, I told you fuckers I was going to be in a Lego movie. And I was in a Lego movie before it was cool to be in a Lego
movie. Ice. Yo, I hate motherfucking Legos. My kid that one of motherfuckers on the floor once. I stepped on that shit. Hurt my foot for a fucking week. Yo, fuck you, Lego. Motherfucker. Seth Rogen.
I'm not an action guy. I don't know if you guys saw Green Hornet. I'm not an action guy.
Ozzy Osbourne.
Look, there's no fucking reason why this should be in a Lego movie.
Sharon! Gilbert Godfrey. It's not so bad that I have to be in a Lego movie. But a Sylvester Stallone movie? No. And as your president of Legoland, Donald Trump.
As your president of Legoland, my fellow Lego people, including the Weeblos, my first order of business, I'm going to go ahead and build a Lego wall around the country. That's the punchline. Thanks, guys. Keep it going for Billy Bear.